Exactly. You use the cards that you've got available. If the system's fucked, then fuck it right back. Welcome, bitches, one and all, to my reaction to Season 3, Episode 3 of Elite, Cayetana and Valerio. So last time we had Guzman basically go completely off the rails and drug slash abduct slash torture Polo, trying to get a confession out of him. And while we did actually get a confession, Guzman and Samu both heard it, it was never going to get to the police. It was never going to go anywhere because by doing this, you are basically incriminating yourself because this isn't a good thing to do, Guzman. You can't just drug and beat a confession out of someone because it can always be taken in the courts as him just saying what he thought he needed to say to get out of that situation. Like, that's not the way to go about things. But luckily, Samu was there. He stopped him. He got him to come to his senses. And hopefully, Guzman can try and find some peace. But I don't think he's going to find it until Polo is in prison. Now, we also had a kiss between Samu and Rebecca. I don't like it. That couple isn't something that I vibe with. I want Rebecca to have someone better than Samu. Not to be a bitch, but it's the truth. So we'll see where it goes, but I don't see them lasting. But yes, with that said, I'm very excited to get back into it. So without further ado, let's go. Has everyone got the same text? What has been revealed? What has been leaked this time? Whoa, I hate when they don't tell us. Polo and Cayetana are the only ones who haven't seen, so I assume it's related to them. Oh shit. Either they create a fake account or they hacked it. Oh my god, that's so bad. Oh my god. Oh, poor Polo. He's going through so much. Fuck off. The only concern I have for Polo right now is what he'll do to other people. Interesting. What is Valerio's angle in all this? Oh, shit. I assume this is the future. So, what? Interesting. I'm trying to think about what this all means. So, Cayetana and Valerio are together in the future, and she's not talking. Well, it seems as though something happened between Valerio and Polo, because there seemed to be like animosity between them, whereas Cayetana was more of a trying to keep the peace kind of don't even think about him, blah, blah, blah. It didn't seem like she was angry at him, so I wonder what goes on that front. La directora nos llamó esta mañana. Nos ha contado lo de la cuenta esa de Twitter. ¿Por qué no nos lo has dicho? Ah, shit. No quiero volver al colegio. De verdad. Eso sería darles la razón. Tienes que ser más fuerte. I mean, that's a lot to ask from him. Let's be real. Ya sabes lo que quiero decir. This is the issue I have with situations like this, where it's like you can tell that the parents are really trying, but we know that he actually did it. And it's just, oh, it's so annoying to see someone be so, like, looked after, if you get what I mean. Like, his parents care about him and being so loving when we know he did actually kill her. Hola, mama. Uh-oh, what's going on here? Papa está bien. He encontrado este folleto de la universidad entre tus cosas esta mañana. What? Do they not want her to go to university? Ese programa es una gran oportunidad. Mi única oportunidad. What is their problem? Oh, they don't want her to go away. For goodness sake, so many people do. That's really nice. I can see a problem forming here because her parents are going to very much approve of this man and still very much not approve of Guzman. So I'm interested to see where their relationships go. However, I know we've only just met this boy, so I'll give him some more time. But at the moment, I do still prefer Nadia and Guzman together. They just seem to have a very good bond. And it's similar when I've been watching Scam and you have a character who is Muslim and a character who isn't. It's like, Do you need that person to be following your faith? Do you need someone? I'm not talking about the rules of the faith right now. Like, I know that in the actual faith and the way that people follow it in different countries, that a lot of the time they are only able to date people of the faith. I'm talking from a practical point of view. If you are dating someone who does not follow the faith, does it really matter that much? Because while your faith is a big part of your life, it's only one part. And for them to not be with you on one part of your life, but be with you on every single other part, do you need them to be part of the faith? You know what I mean? It seems like you're looking for the perfect person that doesn't exist. Damn, why is the detective waiting for Samu?
¿Te importa acompañarme a comisaría, por favor?
Okay, but that's fucking creepy.
Tu hermano parece dispuesto a retirar los cargos.
Podría volver. Como un hombre libre, tendrían que esconderse nunca más.
¿Cómo que parece que está dispuesto?
Yeah, what's the plan here?
Fuimos al mismo colegio, se sentaba en el pupitre de al lado. Somos amigos desde entonces.
Así funcionan las cosas, ¿no? Por chanchullos entre amigos.
Oh, God, Samu, don't go down that route.
No es justo. Pero por una vez puedes utilizarlo a tu favor.
Exactly, you use the cards that you've got available. The system's fucked, then fuck it right back.
Te pedimos una cosa. Llevamos un tiempo haciendo un seguimiento a Sandra López Gallego, la madre de tu amiga. Sabemos que has hecho algunos recados para ella, pero eso no nos sirve para nada.
Oh shit.
Necesitamos pruebas.
Oh shit, they're gonna get him to... Oh my god.
No pienso hacerlo.
That is so smart but fucked up. To get Samu to turn her in. Oh my god. It truly does show how fucked up the justice system is.
Piensa en Nano.
Don't guilt trip him.
Cariño, ¿estás bien?
Sí.
Si necesitas algo, lo dices.
Evidently he is in love. You can tell by the state of his eyes. Oh my god. These are so rough.
A ver, que sí que es cierto que el año que viene me voy a Nueva York y toda la historia, pero... Si no quieres, no me veas. Déjale de cuidar para convencer a tu padre.
Vaya con el perfecto hijo de Allah. Has mentido a mi familia.
Me salgo un poco del camino para volver con más ganas.
¿Qué le dices?
Si quieres saberlo, tendrás que venir conmigo a esa fiesta de Silicon Valley.
No, mis padres no me dejan ir de discotecas.
Tus padres te dejarán ir de discotecas si te acompaña el hijo perfecto de Allah.
I do find it strange how they're trusting him so much, the parents, when they actually don't know him.
Joder. Lo siento, me quedé sin batería.
¿Sí? Pues hazlo ver, porque doble chequi azul, toma pleno.
Oh, that's so awkward, Samu.
Mira, Samu. Yo no sé lo que te pasa, pero me puedo hacer una idea.
Oh, how does someone not have the fucking brain power to realize that they can see when you read messages? That's so awkward, Samu. That makes me feel so uncomfortable. You idiot.
Vengo de la policía.
No joder.
Sí, por lo de mi hermano, la misma mierda de siempre.
Perdóname.
Don't apologize, Rebecca. Like, we know where you're coming from. He was literally...
Yo, fíjate tú.
I mean, it's right that you're insecure because he is still liking the matroness.
A lo mejor,
if that's how you fucking pronounce it.
Si me mete la lengua hasta la campanilla, por ejemplo.
Damn, go off, girl. Tell him what you want.
Venga, vamos a hincar los codos, anda.
¿Desde cuándo quieres estudiar tú?
Pues desde que no quiero acabar como mi madre, cubierta de mierda hasta las cejas.
Ah, shit, talking about her mother when you are about to fuck her over.
Bueno, 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 ¿qué se celebra por acá?
Una fiesta privada, monstruo.
What are they all here talking about?
Tenéis que acabar con esto. No estáis pensando en ella. Estáis pensando en vosotros, porque necesitáis venganza.
No.
Oh, shit, Ander, don't go there.
La vida es muy corta, ¿sabéis? No merece la pena malgastarla.
¿Y tú qué coño sabrás de la vida, Ander?
Oh no, Guzman, don't go there.
Yo le dije que contaría todo, si no se entregaba él mismo a la policía. Le puse contra las cuerdas y casi se mata.
Todo lo que le está pasando a Polo se lo merece. Y ojalá algún día tengas tú tu merecido.
Oh my god, don't say that, you asshole.
¿Hemos acabado?
Oh, this is so fucking stressful and so annoying to watch when people don't know the truth about everything. Because yes, that is what happened with Ander, and that's why we all felt bad for Ander, because he tried to get Polo to turn himself in, and Polo tried to kill himself. Like, if this is someone that Ander has been friends with for so many years, and yes, finding out that he murdered someone is such a big blow, but those feelings that you have for someone don't just go away immediately. So when a old friend of yours is going to kill himself, you're not going to want to make that happen. You know what I mean? I just think that Guzman is so blinded by rage, but I don't blame Guzman for being blinded by rage because his sister's dead because of this man. Like, you can't get annoyed at him for being this way. You know what I mean? It's just frustrating when the truth isn't out for everyone. But also it's very sad for Randa that he had to go through that and have Guzman say, I hope you get what you deserve too, when he literally has cancer.
¿Sabe? Esas películas donde al chico gordito, al que le sudan las manos, nunca le invitan a la fiesta, bueno, pues ese soy yo. Era yo. Entonces, lo único que quiero es que todo sea perfecto.
I do like, this is the problem with situations like this, is when you have been at the bottom of the barrel and you come up to the top, the problem is you get a little bit, power hungry is the wrong word, you get a little bit abusive with your power and you take everything to the extremes. Like, say you didn't have any money and you were poor and on the streets, and then suddenly £1 million is put into your account. You're gonna waste it because you have not slowly got there. You've not slowly built yourself up. It's just been, you've been taken from the bottom right to the top and you don't know what to do with it. And I think he's having the same struggle here where he wasn't invited to anything. He was feeling like a shit person and all that. So now he's like trying to be this super popular, amazing person. And it's just too much. It comes across as too much. And I think he's just gonna have to get used to the life that he's in and sort of look back on the past and not take advantage of anything that he has now, you know? My God, she is so, like, beautiful. Like, as an actress as well, the way that she, like, looks away from the camera and at everyone, it's just so, oh, I love it. Oh, no. You do not want to meet her dad. No, you do not want to meet her dad, mate. Oh shit.
Felicidades por tu salida a bolsa.
Mañana celebramos con una fiesta. Justo estaba diciendo a Carla que
oh, she looks pissed.
Usted y su mujer con ella.
Claro. Encantados.
Oh mate, that is not the way you go about things. You do not guilt trip someone into going. You do not force them into going that way.
¿Qué haces de uniforme? Hoy te toca aquí, mijo.
Me voy a ir.
What?
No merece la pena, ya viste las posibilidades que hay.
No, come on, we're not doing this. We are not doing this.
Ya sé que hemos hablado de esto. Pero estoy harto. De este rollo de ser fuerte y optimista.
Come on, no. Este rollo de lucha. Please.
¿Sabes qué puta presión es esa?
I know it's a lot, I really do, estoy but mal. Please.
No tengo fuerzas para ir.
You do. And if you don't, then let Omar support you. I just, oh, that's so frustrating.
Ya tengo pensado nuestro próximo tweet. Que todo el mundo se entere de que Polo intentó suicidarse.
Oh, Guzman, that is a step too far.
Ya, pero si esperamos un poco. A lo mejor ya está. Pero tú, ¿por qué crees que a lo mejor ya está?
Oh, no, I know that he's like a very bad person, Polo, but talking about suicide in that way in any regard, it's just a no-no. That's something you don't do. Cayetana, please just give up with this man, please. You literally know he killed someone.
Polo. Vete a clase, anda.
This show really does fuck with your head with these scenes, because it makes it feel like you're meant to care about these two, meant to care about them as a couple, but like, in my actual mind, I know that I don't. Oh shit, she actually got him to come out.
Estamos en el salón si necesitáis algo.
Vale, gracias.
Must be really hard as the parents not have him talk to you at all.
Vamos a olvidarnos de Polo, ¿vale? Escúchame, ¿en serio vas a dejar que nos separe?
Aléjate de mí.
Come between us, interesting. Oh my god, that is the bottle that stabbed him. Oh my god. The fact that it's a fucking snake as well.
Sube a cambiarte, anda. Quiero llegar temprano.
Yo no voy a ir.
¿Qué?
Oh shit, this ain't gonna go down well with them, is it?
Carla, no voy a avergonzarme por buscar inversores para salvar las bodegas.
No tiene ni idea de vinos, ni quiere tenerla. Prefiero quedarme aquí a cuidar de mamá.
Yo también intento cuidar de mamá.
No me digas.
Sí, tu madre no está enferma.
Uh-oh, here we go.
Está hundida. Acaba de descubrir que estamos al borde de la quiebra.
Oh fuck.
Si quieres cuidar de mamá.
Why would they be on the verge of bankruptcy? What happened to their business? Is it this whole thing with Carla that's fucked their business?
Ven aquí. Dame dos besos.
Oye, que me alegra que estés bien. Que menudo susto nos diste, joder.
He looks so angry.
Ay, Samuel. Si es que tú eres un buen chico.
Uh-oh, what is she about to say?
Gracias.
No, no, si no es un piropo. A ver, dime, ¿dónde te ha llevado eso?
Going down that route, are you, love?
Tienes que hacer lo que sea mejor para ti y para los tuyos. Y si por el camino jodes a alguien, mala suerte.
Love, you do realize that you've just thrown yourself in the shit because he is now going to plant this listening device and ruin your family.
Dime, ¿qué has conseguido siendo un buen chico?
Oh my god, I love that she's just given him the tools to bring her down. she's literally just convinced him to fuck up her life.
Felicidades.
No esperaba verles aquí.
Bueno, me ha convencido Carla que tenía muchas ganas de venir.
Yeah, sure.
Además, te puede interesar. Estamos buscando inversores y, bueno, mejor te lo explico con más calma.
Bueno, lo siento, pero ahora me están esperando. Disfruta de la fiesta.
For a businessman, her dad is a bit of an idiot when it comes to not showing why you're really there. You know what I mean? Like, you don't reveal that you're really there for the investors.
Era que las bodegas de tu familia no van del todo bien, ¿no?
Oh, shit.
Tu dinero me ha hecho cambiar de opinión.
Romántica.
¿Pero sabes por qué? Porque lo conseguiste tú solo, sin ayuda, sin trampas.
Shit.
¿Qué es lo que más te gusta de mí? ¿Mi cara? ¿Mi cuerpo? ¿Mi apellido?
Shit, all things she can't control and hasn't done anything for. Yep. That is a big thing in life, is a lot of people don't understand that when you, even though it's a good thing, when you give someone compliments all the time that they look pretty or they're beautiful and that's all that they ever get, the parts of them inside, the parts of their personality, the actual things that make them who they are, and they never get compliments about them, it can make you feel really shit and it can really bring down your opinion of yourself and make you so focused on your looks and how you present yourself to the world that you truly do become miserable inside. And unfortunately, that's quite a common thing. And yes, people can say, oh, but they're pretty, like, they don't have to worry about stuff like that. Like, oh, boo-hoo me. But, like, you have to understand that different people have different struggles in their life, and that's obviously something that she goes through. Well, damn. It's the same as Rebecca and Samu for me, though. I don't think they're going to work out together.
Joder, ¿esto es una discoteca o estamos en el inserso?
She's got a point, like, Jesus Christ.
¿Qué tal?
Bien.
Bye. I love Carla's sass.
Cuando le salvaste el culo a Polo pensé que eras una cobarde, pero no fuiste valiente.
Interesting. Her dad's watching, mate. You can't really do much.
Tomaste la decisión que debías para proteger a tu familia. Aunque por ello tuvieses que pagar un precio muy alto.
Just tell him, Carla. Just say my dad's watching. I can't really talk right now.
Perdiste a Lu. Perdiste a Guzmán y me perdiste a mí.
True. That's very true.
Te conocí hace 5 minutos.
Carla, stop downplaying. You can tell she does really care for him. She's just doing it all to keep her dad happy.
Venga, coño.
Hijo de puta.
Oh my god, did Polo come? Oh my god, Polo, what the fuck are you doing? Like, do you just want people to hurt you?
Bueno, hola a todos y gracias por venir. Estamos como una app de ligoteo.
I love how he just randomly went into this whole conversation.
Y es que de bueno eres tonto. Y yo más por dejarme convencer, ¿no te das cuenta?
No, Guzman, you're an idiot for not listening to him more often.
Tienes razón.
Uh-oh, Samu. Yep, he's gonna go do it. Oh shit, how are you gonna do this? What is your game plan? How are you gonna plant this device?
¿Qué tal, pareja?
Oh yeah, we haven't even seen how she's taking it all.
Te lo suplico, no cuentes nada de lo que pasó.
Oh my god, what?
Por favor.
¿Qué quieres, Valerio?
Jesus.
No me gusta que los miren así.
¿Así cómo?
Así como me han mirado a mí toda la vida, vamos.
Yeah, you can understand why Valerio is siding with these two. Siding's the wrong word, because I don't think he's really mentioned anything about if he thinks Paulo is guilty, but...
Tu trigo con Cristian.
Oh.
Que me puso muy cachondo, además.
Oh my god, is this about to be Valerio joining them two?
Somos únicos. Vinemos por eso. Y cheers.
That is technically true. Technically true.
Gastar mi... ¿Mi siguiente comodín?
¿Ah, sí?
Quiero besarte.
Oh, shit.
No, no, no.
Do your wild cards match?
Te beso yo a ti.
Oh, shit. Damn. Go off, Nadia. Oh, God, now I don't know. I'm kind of liking them.
Vamos. Perdona. ¿Te conozco de algo? ¿Eres amigo mío, no verdad?
Is Omar going to reveal it? Is Omar going to say something?
¿Por qué no lo dejas en paz? Joder, macho. Él se lo merece, no me da...
He's going to say it, isn't he? He is, isn't he?
Está enfermo, joder. ¿Cómo que está enfermo?
Oh, Omar, this isn't your place to say. I get why he's saying it, but it's not his place to say.
Eso también tenías que callártelo.
Oh no, this isn't going to go down well. Oh no.
Se lo has dicho. Ander, lo siento. Tenía que... Omar, dije que no dijeras nada. Es asunto mío.
Yeah, I do agree.
¿Qué hice para que me dejases de contar todo lo que te pasa?
Oh.
Guzmán, nada malo. De hecho, tenías razón.
Oh, that's so sad.
Me guardé lo de Polo y se me está pudriendo dentro.
Oh no, Ander, this is not like you getting what you deserve.
No me jodas que por esa tontería no quieres hacer la quimio. ¿Cómo que no quieres hacer la quimio? Que te vayas. Ander.
I mean, Omar, you can't expect him to be happy about you telling everything.
¿Pero qué te quieres morir?
I feel so bad for him because he truly... It's not that, like, Guzman has said this, you're getting what you deserve, and Ander's, like, trying to throw it back in Guzman's face, like, fine then, I won't do chemo and all that. It's not that kind of stupid mentality. The mentality is... Ander is believing it. Ander is genuinely believing that he is getting what he deserves for keeping that secret. And that's just so fucking sad that he has this mentality, because I never blamed Ander for anything relating to Polo. I never blamed Ander for not going forward with it. Do I think that he should have? Yes. But I don't know how I would have reacted in that situation. I don't know how I would have taken everything. I don't know if trying to turn him in and then him trying to kill himself would have affected my decision, you know? He went through a lot of shit, Ander, and it's not like the whole time he was just sitting there trying not to think about it and living his life and being happy. It was eating him up inside from the very beginning, the moment that Polo told him. So I genuinely have never blamed Ander for any of this, and it's just so fucking sad that he blames himself. I like that Guzman is able to see that.
Él es Omar, mi hermano.
Bueno, que está bien tomarse unas vacaciones de las normas, ¿sabes? Para no explotar un día y mandarlo todo a la mierda. Mira, a lo mejor ese era el secreto para no acabar como yo.
Oh, shit.
Omar explotó y lo mandó todo a la mierda. Se fue de casa.
Yep.
¿Qué? Y él no lleva muy bien lo de tener un hijo maricón.
There we go, boom. Uh-huh. Out in the open. I love that he's so open with it.
No sabía que eras... Maricón.
Does he have a problem with it?
¿Pasa algo? No, que va a pasar, no pasa nada, ¿no? Que eso te parece demasiado comodín, ¿no, Malik?
Oh, shit.
Tengo curro. Me voy adentro.
Interesting. Malik's reaction to that is either, because you can take that two ways, either not at, he has a problem with it and it made him a bit uncomfortable, or he himself is having thoughts and that was a bit of a opening up your eyes, because Malik... He definitely doesn't seem like the normal kind of Muslim that you see. He doesn't seem like the person following all the rules, as we've evidently seen. And that when Polo said that, it was kind of like... It felt like that moment where someone has, like, a little secret within them and they've come to face with their reality and it, like, took them back a bit because they wasn't expecting it. Like, it definitely had that vibe from him. So maybe he is a little bit queer himself.
No me importa si te...
Oh shit, Kaya.
¿Qué te importa lo que opine toda esta gente? ¿Vale? Polo, tú no eres lo que todo el mundo piensa que eres, ¿vale? Así que ahora te lo vas a pasar bien, vas a disfrutar y vas a bailar con nosotros. El último. Vamos.
Is this what causes the drift? Do they become a lot closer and then Valerio finds out that he is in fact the murderer and it changes his opinion? Oh shit, there's another tweet come out. Is it about the suicide? Did Samu make it? Oh, Samu! No!
¿Y quién entonces?
Yep. Who do you fucking think? The only other person with access to it. Samu has officially gone off the rails, guys.
Samuel, tú no quieres estar conmigo, ¿no?
¿Qué no es eso?
It is that as well. Like, let's be fucking real, Samu. You don't want to be with her.
¿Puedo dormir contigo esta noche?
Samo.
Bueno, mientras que no durmamos.
Oh, shit. I mean, this is all great and all, but we all know that he's going in there to plant the fucking listening device and ruin her family. How do listening devices work in relation to big crimes like this? Because surely it invades someone's privacy and you can't use it as evidence. Oh no. Oh no.
Lo siento.
No. Perdónanos tú.
Yeah, I don't think she truly took in how serious it was.
Que tú quieras.
Aww.
Quiero desaparecer.
Buscaremos un colegio nuevo. Fuera. Puedes acabar el curso allí, si tú quieres.
I mean, Kaya doesn't want that.
Te vas a ir.
Gracias. Muchas gracias.
If he wasn't guilty and I was watching this scene unsure if he was guilty or not, I would 100% be on board with this because that is a very nice thing to do for your child and a very important thing to do for your child. But the fact that we know that he is guilty, it's like, ugh, so frustrating.
Tú ya estás servido, ¿no?
Oh, guys, I can't handle this. That, oh, my heart is filled. My heart is truly filled.
No querías perderme de vista.
Tranquilo.
Os acabáis de cagarla, pero bien.
¿Qué dices?
Que no quiero estar aquí, que iba a marcharme. Pero ahora no me van a admitir en ningún sitio.
Oh, shit.
Habéis abierto la cuenta y reenviado los tweets a las cuentas de todos los colegios.
Oh, shit. No. Cayetana did it, didn't she? She did it, didn't she, to get him to not move. You little bitch. I know she did it.
Nosotros no hemos ido.
Who do you think? The person who doesn't want you to leave. So selfish, love. For someone who doesn't get what she wants in life, when she has the ability to get it, she fucking tries. What did she say? Does he know? That's the same note, wasn't it, that she put under his door? Oh no. Oh, she has blood on her hands. Interesting. Guys, I am genuinely going down the route right now. I mentioned it last time. If you've seen any of the, or seen or read any Agatha Christie, you would know about the murder on the Orient Express and how everyone had a hand to play in the person's murder. I feel like that might be what this is. I feel like they're genuinely going for the idea that everyone either had a hand in killing him or everyone knows who it is and no one's coming forward. Because that is what it genuinely feels like. That was another amazing episode of Elite. I really did enjoy it. I have to say, though, it was so information-packed that I'm running a bit blank right now. So I'm going to have to, like, run over the episode and go through everything. So let's start with the namesakes of the episode. We have Kaya and Valerio. Let's join Paolo into that as well. But starting with Kaya, she's very manipulative. We've all known this. We all know that she lies to get her way. And it's like I was trying to say earlier, I think that the thing that gets Kaya and the thing that fucks her up is she comes from a very poor background. She comes from a very unprivileged background compared to the rest of the people at this school. And I think that the problem is when someone does not have power, when someone does not have control, they fight even harder and they have hyper control over the things that they can. And she thought in her head, she needs Paolo around, and she had the power. She had the ability to not let him leave her, and she went with it. She ran with it. And I think that that is what's truly got her, is she struggles with having power, feeling like she has control in her life. So the second that she did have control, the second that she thought, I could not allow him to leave and I know how, she went with it, and it's just so fucked up. And even though Paolo doesn't deserve sympathy, Paolo doesn't deserve any love or positive feelings towards any of the people in the audience, that does not change the fact that what Kaya did is very fucked up. Now, moving on to Valerio. Valerio, basically the whole time we've seen Valerio, the whole time that Valerio has been on our screens, it's been clear that he has been trying to find his tribe. He's been trying to find the people that he resonates with. And I think that happened this episode because he truly resonated with the bullying that Paolo was getting in reference to his father bullying him his whole life. And he also recognized the struggles of Kaya, being that he now struggles with money as well. And he knows what it's like to feel like you have to lie to fit in. And I think that he has bonded with him on that front. However, he still does not, in my opinion, I don't think he truly believes that Paulo is a murderer. And I think he's taking this as bullying when he doesn't deserve it. So that's what I'm thinking in terms of why they're not together in the future, why there are issues in the future. Because I think that the truth did come out and Valerio sort of cut ties and couldn't be around him anymore. But if that's not the case, then what the fuck happened? Because it does seem as though they're going down the Carla, Christian, and Paulo route, where they're going to have a three-way relationship, a polyamorous relationship where they're all together. And this time it seems like they might actually form a couple out of it, because Kaya and Valerio were quite bonded in the future. So it seems as though they all bonded and got close to each other, but something happened relating to Paulo that ostracized him from the rest of them. And it could be that Paulo found out that it was Kaya who released it all in the first place and cut ties with them that way, said some shit that split them up. But I don't know. It's all very much in the future right now. I don't truly know what happens, but we know that something happens along the way. Now, let's move on to Paulo himself. He still seems to be living in this dream world where he has done nothing wrong and he is the true victim of this all. And I do genuinely think that he believes it. Even though he knows in his mind that he killed Medina, I think that he has this whole time seen himself as the victim of it all. And while you can say that he was put in a shitty situation and all that, and bullying is never okay, I don't care, because he killed Medina and he spent all this time trying to cover it up. If you kill someone in a rage and you get caught and you go to prison, then good, the process has worked. But when you cover it up for this long and you cover your back and you let Nano get arrested and all shit like that, fuck you. You don't deserve our sympathy. You don't deserve anything from us. You just deserve to be in prison. That is the way that I see it all. Now, moving on from that group, let's talk about Samu. Samu has gone off the rails. He has decided to side with the police and take Rebecca's mum down. And I just find it so fucking hilarious that she was the one that convinced him. That the person that he's going to take down was the one that convinced him to do it. It's just such poetic justice, because while she doesn't seem like a murderer, she doesn't seem like the most awful person in the world, she definitely doesn't seem like a good person. We saw how she humiliated Valerio last episode. And then not only that, but she sells drugs to people of all kinds, including gangsters and people who actually murder people. We've seen that she didn't really care that Samu was almost murdered, because when he came into the house all upset and all that, she was like, oh, come on, it's all good, you're still alive. Like, Jesus Christ, this is not a good woman. So I'm not sad for her that she might be taken down, but I am very sad for Rebecca, because this will truly fuck up Rebecca's life. Because even though her mum seems to be a bad influence on her life, she does love her. It's still her mum. She still takes care of her and supplies money to keep her life going. And while Rebecca has lived a life without this money before, I think that losing it will be a huge blow, not only because once you get used to something and it leaves you, it's a lot bigger of a blow than if you never had it before, but also she won't be able to afford this school. She won't be able to afford to go to this school and get her degrees and get her education that she needs. And it's just so fucking sad, because Samu is doing this to get his brother back and he's doing this to take a bad person down, but he's not really thinking about the collateral damage. So I don't know. I don't really know what I want out of all of this, because I wouldn't be sad if Rebecca's mum got taken down, but I also don't want Rebecca to leave the show because she can't afford to go to the school, you know? It's just all a bit ugh. But I guess we'll have to see how that goes. Now, moving on to Carla. Carla, I do feel bad for Carla. I was a bit iffy with her because of everything that happened last season, because she truly did cover up for Paulo in very big, significant ways. However, everything that Carla has done has been to protect her family. It's been to protect her father. And it's only now that I think she's finally starting to see that it wasn't worth it, because they're still in the shit with money. They're still in the shit in so many ways. Her mother is depressed. Her father is a manipulative asshole. And he just always has his finger over her. He always has this control over her. And I don't even know how that would feel. I can't even comprehend how I would feel to have your parent have so much control over your life and you just feel like you're a puppet. Because that is what it feels like for her. She doesn't have her own voice. She can't voice her own opinion. She can't do what she wants to do because she's so focused on doing what her father wants. And it's just so sad. So while I do think that she did wrong in not turning Paulo in immediately, it's never been for her own gain. It's never been because she wants to keep this life. Her influence and her decision making has all been based around protecting her family, and you gotta respect that. Now, moving on to Yurei. I was trying to talk about it earlier, but I don't know if I truly got it out right. I was trying to say that when you have someone who is very unpopular and is bullied and goes through all the shit that a lot of people do in school and all that. When they suddenly gain money and popularity, they don't know what to do with it. They don't have complete understanding of what entails all of that. And I think that is what's happening to him. He seems to be a little power hungry and a little over the top right now because he's finally getting all the stuff that he ever wanted. And it seems like it's overwhelming him and he doesn't even realize. Seems like it's fully overloading his personality and who he actually is because it's changed his social life. It's changed how he goes about his everyday. It's changed who he is as a person. And I think that's really sad. And I hope that he doesn't truly lose who he was before. If he was unhappy, then I hope that he loses that. I hope he loses the side of him, like the self-doubt, the insecurities. I hope they go away. But I hope he doesn't lose who he is as a person and just gets overwhelmed by all of these other people, all of these very negative financial-based people in his life. Now, him and Carla together, I don't like it because it feels like he's kind of brought her. It feels like he's not going to be good for her. I can't describe it. When I see those two together, it doesn't feel right to me. It feels forced. It feels dirty. I think it's all because of her father's influence, genuinely, because we all know she'll be with Samu. And while I don't agree with that relationship to begin with, the fact that she's being with someone because she can't be with the person she wants because of her father just feels so icky to me. Now, let's move on to Nadia. I have loved Nadia the past two seasons because season one Nadia was so tight-lipped and so controlled by her father that to see her finally let her hair down and actually enjoy her life has just been so beautiful to see. And speaking of Nadia, let's talk about Malik. Malik is a very interesting character and I'm excited to see more of him because he is Muslim, he follows the same faith as Nadia and her parents, but he's very lax with the rules, and he sort of makes his own rules up along the way, and this whole wild card thing is a very modern and very interesting approach to have, where you do follow these rules, but you have a bit of leeway here and there, which is just so different from other Muslims that we've seen in this show. And I do truly like him. Now, let's talk about the conversation that he was having with Nadia and Omar. I was trying to say in the episode, I don't know if I got it out right, but there are two ways that you can take how he reacted to hearing that Omar is queer. You can take it from the way that they tried to show us and the way that it's like implied that it is that he felt uncomfortable in the situation because he is Muslim and there's obviously a bit of a taboo there with being queer and Muslim. Or you can take it the way that I'm taking it, in that Malik is a very open person when he is with Nadia. And he's very open about who he is with everyone that he meets. However, people like that tend to have little things inside them that they don't like to show. They have little things where they're so open about everything else in their life, but these core things they never discuss and they never let out into the open. And I think he might be a little bit queer because when Omar said that, it was like that thing where when you're like gay and you're not out, and you're trying to hide things, and then suddenly out of nowhere, someone asks, are you gay? And it just like makes you panic. It causes the gay panic. It was like that. It's where he was so in his comfort zone of hanging out, chilling and all that, that when Omar mentioned that he's Muslim and queer, it kind of like hit him. And it made him think like, oh shit, like I wasn't prepared for this. This isn't something that I had thought about I would be dealing with this evening. And I think it truly like messed with his brain. So I'm taking it that way because that is truly the way that it seemed. It didn't seem like he was uncomfortable. And I'd be shocked if he was uncomfortable given that he's so lax with the other rules and he's been living such a modern Spanish kid's life that it would be weird to me if we suddenly found out that he did actually have a problem with that. So that's my takeaway, but we will see how that goes. Now, let's go on to Ander. I feel really bad for Ander. I always have. Season 2, he was very controlled by Polo, and there were so many moments where he wanted to come out with the truth, but was kind of manipulated into not doing it, let's be real. He wasn't not saying it because he didn't want to make everything uncomfortable, or he didn't want to be like dragged into it. He wanted to say it because he wanted the truth out, but Polo trying to kill himself really did dig into Ander's heart and make him not want to let his friend die, which is so understandable. Because those feelings for a friend don't go away overnight. They're not just going to disappear. You do care about him. You've grown up with him. And if he's going to kill himself over you doing something, you're not going to want to be that person. You're not going to be the one that wants to do that. So I've always understood Ander's issues with it. And even though I do think that he should have come forward with the truth, I think everyone thinks that, you can understand why he didn't. Now, let's talk about Omar revealing the truth to Guzman. That's just, it's one of those things where while it was needed for Ander, Ander did need someone else to tell Guzman because he was never going to do it. it's one of those things where it's like, you do risk your relationship. And if you truly love them, then you should take that risk. So I appreciate that Omar did, but it doesn't make it good. It doesn't make it like a positive thing that he went and did that, because you betrayed his trust. You betrayed your relationship by going and revealing that to someone. And while Omar did it with the best intentions, you have to be aware that Ander is not going to take it well. So when Ander told Omar to leave, he should have been like, okay, like, I get it. I'll back off. Just let you two have your moment. Because you could not expect Ander to be happy that you have just betrayed his trust. You know what I mean? So I do think that Omar did the right thing, but I also think that Omar should be more aware and more understanding of Ander's feelings. Because while it did have a positive outcome, it wasn't 100% that it was going to be positive. It wasn't 100% that Guzman was going to take it that way. So you need to be careful, Omar. But yes, with all of that said, I believe that covers everything. So on to question time. Right, first up, how do you feel about Malik and Yuray now that you've had more time with them? Ooh, let's start with Malik. I've said it a lot this episode, but let's go over it again. He does seem to be queer. I'm going with that. I'm running with that idea because it just genuinely does seem like that's how he was taking that scene. It didn't feel like an I was uncomfortable, and I wouldn't have expected him to be uncomfortable. It felt more like a surprise and a like, oh God, I didn't expect that. Another Muslim who is queer. You know what I mean? It felt like that. So I'm very excited to see where his character goes, because that is a very complicated storyline and very different from Omar's, because is he open with his family or is he going through the same situation that Omar did? Is he going to befriend Omar? Are they going to actually figure out a way that they can help them both in relation to their parents? Because that would be interesting as well. But yes, moving on to Yuray. Said it again, I think that he is struggling with the idea of having popularity and money now. And he's definitely, it feels like when he said to Carla's dad that you should come with, when Carla clearly expressed that she didn't want to go, it felt very manipulative and I did not like it at all. So we'll see where his character goes. I don't have the best opinion of him right now, and I don't think that him and Carla will work, but we'll have to wait and see. Next up, what do you think about Cayetana? Cayetana's a tough one. I enjoy her character in that she does add a lot of drama to the show. She adds a lot of development for everyone, but as a person, she's fucking awful. Like, she lied about charity to try and get money off of people. She lied to all of her friends for months about who she actually was. She lost her mum all of these jobs by being stupid. And now she's gone and ruined Polo's life. And you can argue that she didn't ruin it, but he's dead. He turns up dead in a few months. So she did essentially cause his death, let's be real, because she didn't let him leave. So she's definitely not a good person. She's very selfish, very manipulative. But I do enjoy her character in the show. Next up, what do you think about Cayetana, Valerio, and Polo? Now, listen, it's the same with Kaya and Polo at the start, where if you take what Polo did and you act as though Polo is innocent, I love it. I'm so on board with that. That's such an interesting trio to have together because they are all unique. They are all outcasts. So I do really enjoy that. But seeing Polo happy with situations annoys me because he should be in prison. He took the life away from Medina that she deserved. So it's just pissing me off that he's getting to have all of these good moments when he doesn't deserve them at all. So that's my take on it. If Polo wasn't a murderer, all on board, but because he is, I'm not on board at all. Next up, what are your thoughts on Samwell betraying Rebecca to try and get Nano to come back? Listen, I understand it. I understand Samu's point of view, and the fact that Rebecca's mum basically got him to go into it is so fucking hilarious. But I just feel so bad for Rebecca. What's she gonna do? She's literally expressed this episode that she wants to get good grades so she doesn't have to be like her mum. But then her mum losing all of her money will not allow her to get her grades. And not only that, but she'll lose her mother. Her mother will go to prison. So it's just like, I don't feel bad for the mum. I think that Samu has every right to do this because it's gonna get his brother and his mum back, which he deserves. But you gotta feel for Rebecca because she doesn't deserve any of this. And lastly, what do you think about Polo being cyberbullied? I don't know. I think that bullying in general was just a wrong thing to do. And while I do think that Polo deserves to be punished, the fact that the legal system failed and he has been set free, it's the bad part of it all. Because if they were bullying him before the trial took place or something, I would have an issue because innocent until proven guilty. But the fact that he was proved innocent when we know that he isn't, this is basically the only way to punish him. And I do think that he does need punishing. So I'm kind of okay with it. The thing that I'm not okay with is the suicide thing. That is just such a taboo thing that even if this guy is a murderer, you don't reference suicide like that in public, because it can have such damaging effects on other people and it can have such damaging effects as a whole. And I think it's one of those things that no matter what, you just don't bring it up in that way. You don't make fun of it because it's not right. So yes, with that said, that was another amazing episode. I enjoyed it. It's very information packed. We're what, 3 out of 8 episodes in. We're starting to see a bit in the future, a bit of things line up. Cayetana had blood on her hand. Valerio seems to be covering something up, but they all seem to be covering something up. So I'm very excited to see how the whole scene plays out. But yes, for now, thank you very much for watching. I've left a link down below to my Patreon. We'll be able to find the early and uncut reactions to Elite and all the other shows that I do. I've also left a link to my Twitch and Discord down below, so be sure to follow them if you are interested. And yes, thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye-bye.